We're at 55 kilograms. William Sullivan of the Army faced the base of Fort Carson out of Las Vegas, Nevada, against Mitch Brown, Lackland Air Force Base, Payson, Utah native. This is 55 kilograms, first match of the dual meet. Both of these teams won their earlier duels, beating the Navy. Air Force beat the Navy in the first round, and the Army beat the Navy in the second round. So the winner of this dual meet will be the team champions at this year's Armed Forces Greco-Roman. Army is the defending champion. Got a star-studded lineup of many athletes that have been on world teams, although this Air Force program has shown some really good skill in Greco, including a few athletes that competed Division I as undergrad cadets here at the Air Force Academy. So, looking forward to bringing you the action. This is an Olympic Trials qualifier. Top two athletes in each weight are eligible. If the champion has not qualified, that athlete goes to the trials. If the champion did qualify already, then the runner-up goes to the Olympic Trials. We got a one-point lead here. Sullivan was hit with passivity, which put Brown on top. He's unable to score from the parterre position. Sullivan successfully works himself back up to the standing position. So ...1-0 lead and favor of Mitch Brown. Neither athlete's been able to really break through with a good attack where they can score here. Brown pretty strong with that two-on-one. Got a hook on the other, on the arm. Attempted arm throw. Sullivan blocks him. Tries to bring him back the other way. Counter takedown for William Sullivan. Gives him a 2-1 lead. And gives him a chance on top. Missed throw attempt by Sullivan. Actually, no, they broke it with the time. So we're 2-1 at the break here. Brown scored first on a passivity. Sullivan countered an arm throw by Brown and was able to get a takedown. So real tight match here. But the Olympic Trials is up for grabs in this weight class. You're seeing Greco-Roman wrestling, which is the traditional style of the sport worldwide. Upper body wrestling, you can't touch or use the legs and you're attacking. Very popular in Europe and Asia. United States, it's not in our school system. So a lot of the good Greco wrestlers in the United States specialize in this style, often early in their careers. Well, Sullivan, by taking the attack, is able to secure a passivity against Brown. Extends his lead to 3-1. And has a chance for a turn on the top. Key for Brown to block any turn attempt here by Sullivan. Parterre defense, it's a key to successful Greco wrestling. 3-1, William Sullivan in the lead. 55 kilograms. Oh, Brown, man, almost got behind there. Sullivan did a good job blocking his throw, but Brown kept with it. He just needs a takedown here. Tie the score at 3. Front headlock position for Brown. Great opportunity here. Brown almost got behind. Sullivan did a good job. Brown working that headlock. He's got 41 seconds. He wants to do a lift. Ooh, nice Sullivan. Counter, no. Wow. That's a 4-point toss. Mitch Brown. Oh, man. Army corner throws in the brick. That right there was one of the better throws of the day. Now they're going to see, and I'm not sure exactly what the Army's challenging. There might have been a step out. There might have been a choke. We don't know. But that fired up the local crowd here. Obviously, we have some Air Force folks here supporting their Air Force team. Mitch Brown was down 2 points, but, man, he got a launch on that one. Actually, they gave him 5, didn't they? 6-3 is the score on the board. Not sure exactly what the challenge would be unless it was the way he executed the throw. Seemed to me like they were in bounds, but that's why they go to the video, right? I'm watching here the replay the officials are seeing. Right there, boom. This is a key call for this match. They're trying to see whether it's 2, 4, or 5, I would think. I mean, the amount of points given on that throw will determine this match. They're clearly, from I can see, just a great exchange of wrestling right there. I think the refs are wondering about exposure on this. They were looking at this one intensely. I mean, it's going to determine the winner, right? I am. Body lock by Sullivan. They go to the edge. Brown plants his feet and goes right into a back arch. Man, I think you'll see this one on the internet somewhere. Okay, here's the call by the jury. Four red. Sullivan gets the points. Well, that'll change the score. 7-1. Huge turnaround. Thirty-two seconds left. Oh. Brown with the double overhook.
More blue.
Gets four. Makes it 7-5. He still has 16 seconds. Step out. 7-6.
One blue.
9 seconds left. Brown goes for it again. Yeah, he gets it. 4-point hip toss. Holy Moses. He's down 7-1. Three moves to win 10-7. That right there is a match. You want to know about the intensity of Armed Forces Wrestling? You just saw it right here. Holy Moses. Man, Brown did not quit. Down 7-1. Gets a 4, a 1, and then a 4. That's 9 points in the last few seconds. They're looking to see whether this was a trip or a clean throw. That's you wonder why people love watching wrestling. You just saw it the last part of this match. Explosive. It really makes the difference on this call. It depends who gets to go to the Olympic trials. And you got to give Brown credit. That guy came back strong. He could have been down 7-1 and given up. Instead, if he wins this, it's a 4-1 and a 4. All within a few seconds. Coaches on the Air Force side are just ecstatic with the way this athlete wrestled. But they got to get the call right. They white paddled it. The throw was not there. The 4 goes away. Match ends 7-6. The challenge worked again for the Army. William Sullivan wins 7-6. Army leads 3-1. That was a crazy match. So here we go, 60 kilograms. Siavesh Sarvestani of the Air Force.